Okay, so this is a character I voiced named Yukako Yamagishi in an anime called JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. Okay. And this character is she's just a normal high school girl. This is Billy Kometz. And this is Jalen. I like them both. And Koichi. This is Zach Aguilar. Zach Aguilar voices Aether in Genshin Impact and other things like Koichi in Diamond is Unbreakable. Anyway, that's me. Or I voice this character. Her name is Yukako Yamagishi.
What the? Kyosuke, it's a girl!
It's a girl!
So
I love the way
Koichi,
he says that.
I hope meeting me here wasn't too much trouble.
Huh? Okay. I just have to say, at the time, I never, ever voiced deeper voiced characters. I mean, this is more like natural, actually. But like at the time, like at this point in my career when I recorded this, it was all high-pitched girls. All of them. Like maybe I did some side characters where I got to like use lower voices, I guess. But this, Yukako, is my first lower voiced role. I actually felt like I was pushing it sometimes. So fun fact.
Too much trouble?
Huh? It wasn't any trouble at all. Really, there's nowhere else I'd rather be. Although I'm not quite sure what this is about.
Wow. Koichi's actually with a girl.
And not just any girl. That's Yukako Yamagishi from my class. Come on, let's get a closer look.
I'm not sure if this is about showing you my homework, but you should probably know my grades aren't all that good and my handwriting sloppy. Though if it's money, I suppose I could give you 1,000 yen. Or maybe you came here to ask me to be the weekly class leader.
I'm afraid it's none of those.
Really? It isn't? Then why did you want to meet me here? If you're
Kagami came after Yukako.
Looking for someone to take in a kitten or puppy. I'm sorry to say I already have a dopey dog named Police.
Koichi, I have to tell you something. Koichi. You need to know that I've fallen madly in love with you!
What did she say?!
I'm sorry, I don't think I heard you right.
I'm sure you did. Every day all I think about is you, Koichi. I've been oh so frightened to utter those words to you. However, if I held it in any longer, my heart was going to burst. But I had to take a leap and tell you my true feelings, even if you were to hate me.
Is this really happening? Is she actually professing her love to me? I wouldn't believe it if I hadn't heard it, but that's what she said. I'm so happy!
Please tell me this isn't happening! Why does Koichi get all the luck? No one's ever said anything like that to me before!
Yeah, there, you big baby. There's no need to cry. But still, holy crap, that Koichi sure is something.
So, Koichi, you must have a girlfriend already.
No, I'm as single as can be. Hang on, you wouldn't tease me about something like this, would you?
No way! I'm serious!
Isn't this so sweet and cute?
I noticed your face has become more chiseled as of late. A strong face brimming with courage and conviction. Also, you're really charming when you smile.
You know, she's honestly making a lot of good points.
I
was not used to talking
too,
like that.
That
was a challenge.
What attracts me to a man more than anything else is potential. And you are potential personified.
Wow, that's the first time anyone's ever said that to me.
But you must be repulsed by homely girls like me. I don't blame you.
What are you talking about? That's not how I see you at all.
Would you come on, you lucky bastard? Quit messing around and seal the deal with that hottie. Just go for it and ask her out already.
Please be honest. Do you hate me?
No, don't be ridiculous.
I love the
music. I couldn't
hate
you even if I wanted to.
Do you love me?
Hold on a second. Don't you think we're moving a bit too fast?
You do hate me.
No, you've got it all wrong. You just caught me off guard when you started talking about love.
Well, which is it? Are you madly in love or toying with my feelings? Answer me, damn it! I poured my heart out to you! And now I've spilled my coffee! All because of your heartlessness!
I don't know what just came over me. I'm so sorry. Forgive me! goodbye. You'll come see me again, I hope.
Okay, that's the scene. That's the scene, but I remember. Okay, so the director on this is Tony Oliver, okay? Tony Oliver directed me all throughout an anime called Love Live, where I played a really cutesy girl named Rin Hoshizora, and she was like just so sweet and fun, and I think I recorded Hunter Hunter with him too, where I was like a cutesy girl in that too. He had only heard me do like cutesy voices. Try to watch the original to hear what she sounded like, and it is deeper. Like, she's deeper. And I was surprised that I was cast as this. And I remember even Tony was like, okay, she does sound deeper in the original J, but because mommy cast you, I guess we're gonna go with like a lighter tone for her. So we actually recorded her a little bit higher pitched at first. And we recorded like a whole session, and we had to redo it because Mami Okada, the casting director, when she listened to it, she was like, no, I wanted her to be a like lower voiced. She can do it. And Tony was confused, and he was like, okay, I guess that's what we're gonna do. So we recorded it again like this as it came out, and when we got to this part,
guard, when you started,
not for me, damn it! I poured my heart out to you, and now I spilled my coffee all because of your heartlessness.
That yes, like all of that. I remember I looked through the glass because we're separated, like the voice actor is separated from the director and the engineer on the other side. I looked at Tony's face and he was just like, remind me to never piss you off. And I remember he was just like, I didn't know you had that in you. I remember. Okay, so I recorded Sword Art Online Gun Gale. Or it's alternative Gun Gale. And I recorded, what's her name? Fukajiro. So there was these three characters. Pito Hui, Len, and Fukajiro. Okay? I only got the auditions for this girl and this girl. The two cutesy characters, as usual, because I only got like cutesy character auditions. But I really wanted to audition for this character, Pito Hui. I was like, I straight up asked for it. I had never before directly asked for an audition. And then, I don't know if you've seen it, I didn't get this role, I got this role. However, I still submitted on audition, and shortly afterwards, I was cast as this character, Yukako Yamagishi in JoJo's. And I was very surprised. I was like, wait, wait, that means that my, like, I took a chance just to say, hey, I can do this. I swear I can do more than just high-pitched little girls. And they gave me a chance.
To know
that, like, I never did voices like this at this point. I never did it until this role.
I've fallen madly in love with you.
Like, I got to use a deeper register. And that was, it meant the world to me. Like, just to even, like, I don't know how to explain it. It changed a lot for me personally. I think, like, just being able to show that I can do this. And also, the range in which, like, she's, like, so, like, you see her flip from being, like, this kind of sweet, kind of shy girl to this monster.
I poured my heart out to you.
So all you see is the final product of this, right? Whenever it's streamed somewhere. But like for me, this was a turning point in my career. For me, this was like, it was like I've been given a chance, and now I can prove myself that I can do this. And from this role onwards, I started booking a much wider range of characters. And I felt very proud of myself. That's all I wanted to say. That's all I wanted to share.